kind of weird when you think about it. Someone just bought a company recently. Elon Musk just bought a company. You know how he bought the company? He sold Tesla stock, which is very rare and unusual and not easy to do, but he sold stock to buy another company. And he bought it based on market capitalization. Twitter was public, and now it's not. That's just a point of interest. What do you think Starbucks is worth if you wanted to buy it? Just guess. A few million? Is that your best guess? A billion? So you went from a few million to a billion. What do you think? It's right there. How much is it? Can you see it? Market cap. Look at the. Huh? 100. Can you see it?
Yeah, what's that?
124 billion, 20,963,000. So, 124 billion from. I mean, you didn't know, but now you do. How much do you think? Let's just do like quick market cap. What do you think Ford is worth? This is the company you want to study. Just what do you think it's worth? You think it's more than Starbucks? Do you think Ford is more than Starbucks? No? So coffee. Okay, let's. How much is it worth?
50
billion. A coffee joint is worth more than the oldest car company in the United States.
Is that because there are like a lot of more car companies than?
Well, that's a great question. And why? Why? Like, technically, why? The stock price, how much is the stock price? $16? How much is the stock price for Starbucks? 110? So that matters. And then how many shares outstanding? That's the technical reason. But maybe the competitive landscape, it's an old, you know, there's a million reasons why. How about Chipotle? Anyone studying Chipotle in here for your company? Do you like Chipotle? Yeah. No? Do you? How often do you go? Once every 2 weeks. Do you know how much Chipotle is valued? Millions, billions, gazillions. A burrito store is worth the same amount as Ford. Isn't that crazy? What's their stock price? $1,700! Huh? You're animated now. I heard a few Jesuses. Jesus. It's just a burrito. Isn't that cool? I mean, I've only shown you three things and this is how you need to study. That's pretty crazy, isn't it? Chipotle, the burrito store. Let's go back to Starbucks.
Professor?
What?
Does this like website also show how many outstanding shares that you have?
Let's see. I don't think so.
There's a number of shareholders.
Oh, number of shareholders. It's a very tricky one. Listen, what makes a stock price go up or down? Be more specific. Can you say it louder so she can hear you in the back?
The thing that determines the stock price usually is how the market or the people think the company is going to perform. So, let's say Apple's about to drop a new phone. Their stock price will probably go up in anticipation for that phone.
Maybe. Maybe not. Depends. You're right. Bottom line, the market decides. That's a bit vague, so let's tighten that up. A whole lot of different people and organizations collectively say and analyze analysts, Wall Street analysts, investment bankers. Fundamentals. So too does Warren Buffett. The intrinsic value is a big thing. You know what that means? It means the value, say, of the brand, the management team, are they competent? In other words, what makes this stock or company's value or determines its value 5 years from now? Do you have a good sense that Chipotle will be around winning 5 years from now? Do you have a great sense that Ford will be around 5 years from now? I do, but I have a whole lot of uncertainty about whatever they're going to be making. Don't you? They just canceled all of their cars and they're making like one. They're making electric kind of trucks. And they're making things where they have where they're valued most, trucks and a Mustang electric car. That's fine, they're in transition. But that's why it's $7 or whatever it is, $12 a share. So let's continue. What else do you have? I mean, the fundamentals are just right before you. I need to show you the greatest thing of all time. What? I encourage you to explore Mergent. You might go down rabbit holes and spend 3 hours here. I've got 5 more minutes. Okay? But thank you. Well done. So look at these tabs here. Ownership, company financials. If you put company financials, you can get balance sheets, income statements, retained earnings, cash flow, and so on. That's pretty cool, right? Huh? Hey, let's get an income statement for the last 5 years. Well, there it is. But I want to show you this one here. Oh, annual reports. What is a 10K? Do you know what a 10K is? It's not a run, that's 10K. You know what it is?
I know it's a tax report.
A 10K is a tax code required for public companies to produce essentially what we would call an annual report. 10K is an annual report required by the Securities and Exchange Commission. So, when you're studying your company, let me give you an example. Stay with me. In a couple of weeks, we're going to study price strategy. One of the most important things about pricing, what do you think is one of the most important things about pricing?
I would say like part of the sweet spot where like the customer will be happy with that price and you don't really want
to. For sure, like what is the customer willing to pay? But also, there's another piece of the puzzle. Think operationally. Do you think that Chipotle has figured out how much it costs to produce one burrito? I'll bet you they have it down. Now, listen. What do you think the cost of production of Chipotle is? Well, their main product is probably not just a burrito, but it's a combination of a few things that most people buy. A drink, a burrito, and chips, or whatever. What do you think the total price per event is? You should know, you go every 2 weeks. $15? $20? $17. What? Let's go with 15. How much, this is marketing. How much does it cost to produce, let's call $15 one unit. Okay. How much does it cost to produce one unit? I'm gonna say it's more than that. Well, you said three. That's a huge margin. Per unit sold. The average industry profitability for all industries combined is what? I know you don't know the answer, but what do you think? 3%? It's actually about 15%. However, it depends on the industry. Grocery stores are about 1%. It's the worst business in the world. Hospitality and airlines, that kind of stuff, also terrible. Between 5 and 7%. Soft drinks, 40%. You follow me? How to design a strategy. So let's back up. If the cost per unit is $15, total price point is about 15 for a Chipotle dining experience, we have to know the cost per unit. I'm going to teach you this later. The point is, how do you find out any of this? One of the ways you might is look at a 10K. For example, write this in your notes. You'll be ahead of the game 2 weeks or 3 weeks. There are usually three costs that we use to determine the cost of production. One of them is literally operational costs. How much does it cost to make the burrito? Tortilla, the meat, the stuff, the cup, you got all that? But that's not enough, because there's other things that are part of that. There are administrative costs to run the whole company. What other costs? Sorry? Employees. Usually we call those administrative expenses. Long story short, that stuff. Sometimes you might get lucky and they're in a 10K, which is available through the financial records. The 10K, and you've done 10Ks, they're awful. Right? They can be, they're usually awful. They sound like government documents for an IRS agent. However, you might find, because it's kind of required, that you might see marketing expenses. You might get lucky. Market our product. Research and development costs.